A very good morning to all my dear students. I am Shalini, your English teacher, and today I am going to explain chapter 1, A Triumph of Surgery, from your book Footprints Without Feet. Before starting, I would like to introduce Mr. James Herriot, the writer. He was born on 3rd October 1916 at Sunderland, UK. He died on 23rd February 1995 at Thurlby, UK, United Kingdom. He was a British veterinary surgeon and author. He graduated from Glasgow Veterinary College in 1939. He returned to England to become a veterinary surgeon in Yorkshire, where he practiced for almost 50 years. In this story, there was a small dog who was over pampered and overfed by his rich mistress, and as a result he fell seriously ill. What and how the doctor has done to rescue that dog is all about this story. I was really worried about Ricky this time. I had pulled up my car when I saw him in the street with his mistress, and I was shocked at his appearance. He had become hugely fat, like a bloated sausage with a leg at each corner. His eyes, bloodshot and rheumy, stared straight ahead, and his tongue lolled from his jaws. Doctor is saying, Mr. James Herriot is saying, that he is quite worried about Tricky this time, as he is getting fat, and he was like a bloated sausage. And his eyes are bloodshot, बिल्कुल लाल उसकी आँखें हो चुकी हैं, एंड ड्रीमी मीन्स वाटरी आईज, स्टेयर्ड स्ट्रेट अहेड. ही वॉज नॉट कैपेबल, ही वॉज नॉट एबल टू लुक प्रॉपरली, टू सी प्रॉपरली, एंड हिज टंग वॉज लोल्ड आउट ऑफ हिज जॉज, बाहर निकली हुई उसकी जीभ. मिस पम्फ्री हैसेंड टू एक्सप्लेन, he was so listless, Mr. Herriot. He seemed to have no energy. I thought he must be suffering from malnutrition. Jaldi se, Mrs. Pemphrey started explaining, he's so restless, Mr. Herriot. Listless means energyless, restless, and I think he is suffering from malnutrition, means isme nutrition ki kami ho gayi hai. So I have been giving him some little extras between मील्स टू बिल्ड हिम अप, और इसलिए खाने के बीच बीच में उसको कुछ एक्स्ट्रा चीज़ें दे रहे हैं. फॉर एग्ज़ाम्पल, सम माल्ट, कॉड लीवर ऑयल एंड अ बाउल ऑफ हॉर्लिक्स एट नाइट टू मेक हिम स्लीप. नथिंग मच रियली, मीन्स ज़्यादा कुछ नहीं दे पा रहे हैं. ओनली सम माल्ट, सम कॉड लीवर ऑयल, अ बाउल ऑफ हॉर्लिक्स एट नाइट सो दैट ही कुड स्लीप बेटर. ओनली दिस मच, ही सो इनोसेंट लेडी. And did you cut down on the sweet things as I told you? Doctor ne pucha ki, have you cut down his sweet? Oh, I did for a bit, but he seemed so weak, I had to relent. Itna weak lag raha hai ye, Mrs. Pemphrey is saying. She's explaining, I just tried to cut a bit, but main isko mana nahi kar pati, just because he is so weak. He does love cream cakes and chocolate, so I can't bear to refuse him. Or isko he love cream cakes and chocolates so much, I can't refuse him, as she loved so much Tricky, so she can't refuse anything. I looked down again at the little dog. That was the trouble. Tricky's only fault was greed. Tricky was greedy, and he can't refuse food. That was the only trouble, and he was getting fat, and ill. He had never been known to refuse food. He would tackle a meal at any hour of the day or night. Means वो दिन या रात में कभी भी कुछ भी खा सकता था. That was the only trouble. And I wondered about all the things Mrs. Pumphrey hadn't mentioned. Are you giving him plenty of exercise? Now doctor had asked about the exercises. Well, he has his little walks with me, as you can see. But Hawken, the gardener, had been down with lumbago, so there has been no ring throwing lately. It means he was not exercising. Ricky was not exercising, as her gardener is suffering from lumbago. Lumbago means back ache. He was suffering from back ache. That's why he is not able to make him exercise or make him play. That's why Ricky was taking all the rest and only food and food. I try to sound severe. Now I really mean this. If you don't cut his food right now down and give him more exercise, he is going to be really ill. You must harden your heart and keep him on a very strict diet. Now, Mr. Harriet, the doctor, had told her, Mrs. Mumphrey, that you have to cut down his meal and his sweets, and you have to make him follow a strict diet. Otherwise, he will be seriously ill. Mrs. Pumphrey wrung her hands. Oh, I will, Mr. Harriet. I am sure you are right, but it is so difficult, so very difficult. She set off, head down, along the road, as if determined to put the new regime into practice immediately. She was looking determined, but definitely it is quite difficult for her to cut down the meal, as she loves so much Tricky. इसलिए वो टिक्की का खाना बिल्कुल कम नहीं करेंगी. आई वॉच देयर प्रोग्रेस विद ग्रोइंग कंसर्न. ट्रिकी वॉज टॉटरिंग अलॉन्ग इन हिज लिटिल ट्वीट कोट. ही हैड अ होल वार्डरोब ऑफ दीज कोट्स फॉर द कोल्ड वेदर एंड अ रेन कोट फॉर द वेट डेज. ही स्ट्रगल्ड ऑन ड्रॉपिंग इन हिज हार्नेस. आई थॉट इट वुडंट बी लॉन्ग बिफोर आई हर्ड फ्रॉम मिसेस पम्फ्री. Mr. Harriet was watching Tricky continuously, and he knew Tricky is going to be seriously ill. And on that day, Tricky was tottering, means walking slowly, in his little tweed coat. Tweed coat. Tweed is a kind of cotton, and Tricky was having a whole lot of coats for winter season and raincoats for rainy season. And Mr. Harriet was expecting a news from Mrs. Pumphrey about the illness of Tricky. The expected call came within few days. Mrs. Pumphrey was distraught. She was quite disappointed, and she was in pain. Tricky would eat nothing, refused even his favorite dishes, and besides, he had bouts of vomiting. As he was expecting, Mrs. Pumphrey called him within few days. And what was the problem with Tricky? He was not eating anything and he was continuously vomiting. He had bouts of vomit, and all this is because of overeating, over pampering. He spent all his time laying on his rug, panting, didn't want to go for walks, didn't want to do anything. And he was seriously ill. Tricky was seriously ill. और वो पूरे टाइम अपने लेटा रहता है और पेंटिंग मीन्स ही वॉज क्राइंग विद पेन एंड ही डिडन्ट वॉन्ट टू डू एनी थिंग. ही वॉज जस्ट लेइंग. आई हैड मेड माई प्लान्स इन एडवांस. द ओनली वे टू गेट ट्रिकी आउट ऑफ द हाउस वॉज फॉर अ पीरियड. आई सजेस्टेड दैट ही इज हॉस्पिटलाइज फॉर अबाउट अ फोर्टनाइट टू बी केप्ट अंडर ऑब्जर्वेशन. So Mr. Harriet was already planned, and he told Mrs. Pumphrey that we have to take Tricky for almost 15 days to the surgery, to the hospital, and he has to be kept there and the poor lady almost swooned. She was sure he would pine and die if he did not see her every day. And Mrs. Pumphrey, the poor lady, bichari, she thought Ricky would die and would pine. He would die, almost die, और बहुत ज़्यादा परेशान हो जाएगा, दुखी हो जाएगा अगर वो मिसेस पैम्फ्री को रोज़ नहीं देखेगा. बट आई टुक अ फर्म लाइन, ट्रिकी वॉज वेरी इल एंड दिस वॉज द ओनली वे टू सेव हिम. इन फैक्ट आई थॉट इट बेस्ट टू टेक हिम विदाउट डिले. और मिस्टर हैरिट वॉज क्वाइट फर्म ऑन दैट लाइन कि ट्रिकी इज़ वेरी इल और इसको बचाने का सिर्फ एक ही रास्ता है कि वी हैव टू टेक हिम to the hospital or surgery. And followed by Mrs. Pumphrey's wailings, I marched out to the car carrying the little dog wrapped in a blanket. He wrapped the little dog in a blanket and he took him to the car. The entire staff was roused and maids rushed in and out bringing his day bed, his night bed, his favorite cushions, toys and rubber rings, breakfast bowl, lunch bowl, supper bowl. Realizing that my car would never hold all this stuff, I started to drive away. Now you can see how over pampered was that dog, Tricky. He was having his day bed, his night bed, uske favorite cushions the. He was having toys and rubber rings, his breakfast bowls, his lunch bowls, his supper bowls, all the things, all the stuff. Mrs. Pumphrey kept it with him. Now the doctor started driving away. As I moved off, Mrs. Pumphrey, with the despairing cry, threw an armful of the little coats through the window. I looked in the mirror before I turned the corner of the drive. Everybody was in tears. Mrs. Pumphrey and her staff was all crying just because of Tricky. Out on the road, I glanced down at the pathetic little animal gasping on the seat by my side. I patted the head and Tricky made a brave effort to wag his tail. Poor old lad, I said, you haven't a kick in you, but I think I knew I cure you. Tricky was so listless, he was so energyless, he was so ill that he was not even able to wag his tail. अपनी पूंछ भी हिलाने के लायक नहीं था. But doctor was hoping that I will cure the dog. At the surgery, the household dogs searched around me. Tricky looked down at the noisy pack with dull eyes and when put down lay motionless on the carpet. Surgery में there were other household dogs and they searched around the doctor as he entered, and doctor put Tricky on the carpet and he lay motionless. He was not able to move himself. The other dogs, after sniffing around him for a few seconds, usko sunga for a few seconds, and after that they all decided that he was uninteresting object and ignored Tricky on the very first day. I made up a bed for him in a warm loose box next to the one where the other dogs slept. For 2 days I kept an eye on him, giving him no food but plenty of water. Mrs. Pumphrey has given his day bed, his night bed, his favorite cushions, but the doctor had not used anything. He made his bed in a warm and loose box next to the other dogs, and for 2 days he had not given him any food but only a plenty of water. At the end of the second day he started to show some interest in his surroundings, and on the third he began to whimper when he heard the dogs in the yard. For 2 days he was just laying motionless and he was drinking only water. And at the end of the second day, he started showing some interest in the other dogs and his surroundings. And on third day, he started whimper when he heard, means he was making some noise when he heard other dogs in the yard. When I opened the door, Tricky trotted out and was immediately engulfed by Joe, the greyhound, and his friends. After rolling him over and thoroughly inspecting him, the dogs moved off down the garden. Tricky followed them, rolling slightly with his surplus fat. On the third day, Tricky went into that group, and all the dogs started playing with him, and Tricky moved into the garden with all the other dogs. Later that day, I was present at feeding time. I watched while Tristan slopped the food into the bowls. Tristan was his cook, taking care of dogs. So on third day, at the feeding time of dogs, the doctor was present there and he was watching everything. There was the usual headlong rush followed by the sounds of high-speed eating. Every dog knew that if he fell behind the others, he was liable to have some competition for the last part of his meal. It means all the dogs were busy finishing their supper, finishing their food, because they knew if they were fallen behind, other dogs will share their food. When they had finished, Tricky took a walk round the shining bowls. Jab sabne khana kha liya, then Tricky took a round on the round among the shining bowls, and he licking casually inside one or two of them, and he licked one or two bowls. It means he was a little bit hungry. Next day, an extra bowl was put out for him, and I was pleased to see him jostling his way towards it. And on fourth day, the doctor, Mr. Harriet, given him his bowl for food. From then on, his progress was rapid. He had no medicinal treatment of any kind, but all day he ran about with the dogs, joining in other friendly scrimmages. He discovered the joys of being bowled over, tramped on, and squished every few minutes. It means Tricky was over pampered in that house, at Mrs. Pemfrey's house. And now, from fourth day, he was eating some normal food like the other dogs, and now he was playing and enjoying his life with other dogs. He was quite happy here, and he started recovery, means his extra fat is melting. Jo bahut zyada mota ho gaya tha wo extra fat is melting. Okay. And he became an accepted member of the gang, of the dog's gang. An unlikely silky little object among the shaggy crew, lighting house at night. He had never had lighting like a tiger of his share at mealtime, and hunting rats in the old hen house at night. He had never had such a time in his life. So that little dog was now started fighting for his meals, and he started hunting rats at night, and he was never been indulged in such activities, so he was quite happy. All the while, Mrs. Pemfrey hovered anxiously in the background, ringing a dozen times a day for the latest bulletins. I dodged the questions about whether his cushions were being turned regularly or his correct coat worn according to the weather, but I was able to tell her that the little fellow was out of danger and convalescing rapidly. Convalescing means recovering. Ab theek hone laga hai. Or in the meanwhile, Mrs. Pemfrey was ringing regularly, calling regularly to doctor, and as she was quite worried about that dog, Tricky. Doctor used to answer her calls, but he dodged the questions about his cushions, his coats, his favorite toys, his beds. Aise questions ko wo taal diya karte the, inke answer nahi dete the. But one day, he told Mrs. Pemfrey that Tricky is out of danger and he is convalescing rapidly, means he was recovering very soon, very fast. The word convulsing seemed to do something to Mrs. Pumphrey. She started to bring round fresh eggs, 2 dozen at a time, to build up Kiki's strength for a happy period. My partners and I have 2 eggs each for breakfast. But when the bottles of wine begin to arrive, the real possibilities of the situation begin to dawn on the household. जैसे ही मिसेस पेम्फ्री ने सुना रिकी इज रिकवरिंग, ही वॉज कन्वेल्सिंग, शी स्टार्टेड ब्रिंगिंग फ्रेश एग्स एटलीस्ट 2 dozen एट अ टाइम एंड डॉक्टर मिस्टर हैरियट वॉज नॉट गिविंग एनीथिंग टू रिकी एज ही वॉज रिकवरिंग रियली. तो डॉक्टर एंड हिज पार्टनर्स वर इन्जॉइंग, टोटली इन्जॉइंग 2 eggs इन द ब्रेकफास्ट. And very soon she started giving wine also. And doctor and his partners were enjoying all the wine and eggs. It was to enrich Ricky's blood. Wine was there to enrich Ricky's blood. Lunch became a ceremonial occasion with 2 glasses of wine before and several during the meal. As I told you, doctor and his partners were enjoying that wine. They used to take 2 glasses of wine before lunch and several glasses during the meal. We could hardly believe it when the brandy came to put a final edge on Ricky's constitution. For a few nights, the fine spirit was rolled around, inhaled and reverently drunk. Along with wine, she started sending brandy also for Ricky. And the doctor and his friends were enjoying all the things. They were days of deep content, starting well with the extra egg in the morning, improved and sustained with the midday wine, and finishing luxuriously round the fire with the brandy. So in the morning they used to enjoy eggs, and in the afternoons they used to take wine, and at night they used to take brandy, and they were enjoying all the luxuries in the name of Ricky. It was a temptation to keep Ricky as a permanent guest, but I knew Mrs. Pumphrey was suffering, and after a fortnight felt compelled to phone and tell her that the little dog had recovered and was awaiting collection. And the doctor and his staff wanted to keep Ricky as their permanent guest, but doctor knew that Mrs. Pumphrey was in pain. She was suffering a lot without Ricky. So after a fortnight means after 15 days, he has to tell Mrs. Pumphrey that little dog had recovered, ab wo theek ho gaya, and he was awaiting collection, ab aap usko le jaiye. He was waiting for you. Within minutes, about 30 feet of gleaming black metal drew up outside the surgery. The chauffeur opened the door, and I could just make out the figure of Mrs. Pumphrey almost lost in the interior. Her hands were tightly clasped in front of her. Her lips trembled. Oh, Mr. Harriet, do tell me the truth. Is he really better? And as he told Mrs. Pumphrey that Ricky is waiting for collection, within few minutes, Mrs. Pumphrey was there with her 30 feet long gleamy black metal car. 30 feet lambi si badi si gaadi lekar ke Mrs. Pumphrey apne Ricky ko lene aa gayi. And she was quite worried, and she asked Mr. Harriet, मुझे सच बताइए, इज ही रियली बेटर? येस, ही इज़ फाइन, देर इज़ नो नीड फॉर यू टू गेट आउट ऑफ द कार, आई विल गो एंड फेच हिम. मैं उसे लेकर आता हूँ. आई वॉक थ्रू द हाउस इन टू द गार्डन. अ मास ऑफ डॉग्स वॉज हर्टलिंग राउंड एंड राउंड द लॉन, एंड इन देयर मिडस्ट ईयर्स फ्लैपिंग टेल वेविंग वॉज द लिटिल गोल्डन फिगर ऑफ ट्रिकी. इन 2 weeks ही हैड बीन ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड इन टू अ lithe, hard-muscled animal. He was keeping up well with the pack stretching out in great bounds, his chest almost brushing the ground. It means within 15 days, Tricky has been transformed totally. From a bloated sausage, he was now a strong muscled dog. I carried him back along the passage to the front of the house. The chauffeur was still holding the car door open, and when Tricky saw his mistress, he took off my arms in the tremendous leap and sailed into Mrs. Pumphrey's lap. Mr. Harriet carried Tricky in his arms, and as Tricky saw his mistress, Mrs. Pumphrey, he ran towards her. उनकी गोद में भाग के चला गया. शी गेव अ स्टार्टल्ड ओ एंड देन हैड टू डिफेंड हर सेल्फ एज ही सॉन्ड ओवर हर लिकिंग हर फेस एंड बार्किंग. ड्यूरिंग द एक्साइटमेंट आई हेल्प द शोफर टू ब्रिंग आउट द बेड्स, टॉयज, कुशंस, कोट्स एंड बाल्स, नन ऑफ विच हैड बीन यूज्ड. एज ट्रिकी एंड मिसेस पम्फ्री वॉज मी वर मीटिंग, डॉक्टर हेल्प द शोफर. शोफर मीन्स ड्राइवर. ड्राइवर टू कलेक्ट ऑल द बेड्स, टॉयज, कुशंस, कोट्स, बाल्स, जिसमें से कुछ भी यूज़ नहीं हुआ था वो सब वापस रखा. एज द कार मूव्ड अवे, मिसेस पम्फ्री लीन्ड आउट ऑफ द विंडो, टीयर्स शोन इन हर आइज, हर लिप ट्रेम्बल्ड. ओ मिस्टर हैरियट, शी क्राइड, हाउ कैन आई एवर थैंक यू, दिस इज अ ट्रायंफ ऑफ सर्जरी. व्हेन कार स्टार्टेड मूविंग, मिसेस पम्फ्री लीन्ड आउट ऑफ द विंडो, विंडो के बाहर निकली, एंड शी सेड कि मैं आपको थैंक यू कैसे कह पाऊंगी, दिस इज़ अ ट्रिम्फ ऑफ सर्जरी, ये सर्जरी की जीत है. सर्जरी मीन्स उस हॉस्पिटल की जीत है. सो दिस इज ऑल फॉर टुडे. वी विल मीट इन नेक्स्ट सेशन विद सम न्यू टॉपिक. टिल देन टेक केयर एंड गुड बाय.